Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We look at the SGI graph with magnitude 5.5 in larger earthquakes, and we see a huge cluster on the second, third, fourth in yes. And remember, I said in the previous update, the lunar conjunctions deserve attention, especially the one with Jupiter. And this cluster here, it included 6.4, it included 6.2 on the 1st and the 2nd of April. And then after this lunar conjunction with Jupiter, two magnitude 6.9 earthquakes. The probability of that occurring, it happened within 30 hours, is about 11%. You may look up the previous update where I emphasized this lunar conjunction with Jupiter. And if we look further back, we had this quadruple conjunction with Earth, Venus, Mercury and Neptune. It resulted in two magnitude 7 earthquakes, one in Myanmar and the other one in Tonga on the 30th after the Earth-Mercury-Neptune conjunction. And then we had the third conjunction on the 31st, that was Venus-Mercury-Neptune. And then this lunar, the two lunar conjunctions. Like I said, the synchronicity, critical planetary geometry, critical lunar geometry. And then we have this cluster of strong earthquakes. We can look at this in a statistic way. We have the distribution of daily magnitude 5.5 plus earthquake counts. We see a tiny green peak there, that's the background distribution of those magnitude 5.5 in larger earthquakes that we always emphasize. And I always say they tend to occur in clusters with planetary and lunar geometry, specific geometry. And indeed, we see here within one day, we have pretty much a cluster there, and then it goes down with the second and third day. These are statistics, right? I also said repeatedly in previous updates, we still see an absence of magnitude 7.8 in larger earthquakes. And we can also see, if you look at the last 25 years, there is indeed this absence here starting in 2021. And then we had one in 2023 in Turkey. But other than that, no 7.8 plus earthquakes. And if we look at the magnitude 8 in larger earthquakes, they are absent since 2021. So that is still there, and we know some fault sections on the planet are probably under pretty high stress, and some of them may have reached the tipping point. Which one exactly, we don't know. We try to actually indicate that with atmospheric anomalies. It isn't perfect, but that's what we do, and that's what we update on our website and social media. All right, so let's have a look at the next time frame from the 7th until the 16th. We see a high lunar peak that is on the 10th, and that's because three planetary lunar conjunctions are converging there with Venus, Saturn, and with Neptune. We know that because, as seen from Earth, we have this grouping of Venus, Mercury, Saturn, and Neptune in one region of space, and that results in this convergence of lunar conjunctions. We see Mercury, Sun, Uranus. Well, actually, I have to go back a bit because today we have Earth, Venus, Saturn, as I set in the previous update. But I don't think Earth, Venus, Saturn is going to do much, although Mercury is close. It is an edge case. Yeah, it could result in some stronger seismic activity. Be on extra alert just in case. But I don't think Earth, Venus, Saturn itself is going to do much. But this high lunar peak there on the 10th, preceded by Mercury, Sun, Uranus, that's the red peak. And then we have Venus, Mercury, Neptune. Again, they're still grouped in space. And there is some 48 hours in between. That's also an edge case. It could result in the combination of Mercury, Sun, Uranus and Venus, Mercury, Neptune that could result in stronger seismic activity. In a worst case scenario, I don't think it's going to happen, but in a worst case scenario, it could result in a 7.8 or larger earthquake. No, 7.4 or larger earthquake based on the statistics. And that could happen around the 14th, 13th, 14th, and it's also the time of the full moon that we have late on the 12th. So in this entire time frame, I think that 13th, 14th is probably most critical. There is the potential for increased seismic activity. And if we consider the high lunar peak, we can see the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes, the higher 5 and maybe even 6 magnitude around the 11th. So 11th, 12th, 13th, is critical, and there is a slight possibility of a major earthquake around the 13th. We recently had two magnitude 7 earthquakes. Statistically, we don't see them too often, about 24, 25 days in between on average, but they don't occur on average. So there is a slight possibility there around the 13th, in my opinion, 13th, 14th maybe. If we look at the solar system, we see this near convergence, this conjunction cluster. It isn't close. It's on the edge of 48 hours. This is the typical time window. We see Venus, Mercury, Neptune. That's the purple line. And we see Mercury, Sun, Uranus. And like I said, about 48 hours in between, there is a slight possibility that it results in larger seismic activity. But the lunar peak is in between. So again, be on extra alert there following around the time of the full moon. But if there's going to be a seismic activity, it probably stays in the 6 magnitude range, probably. This is the update. Check out the website for the latest updates and also the social media, especially atmospheric anomalies. Stay safe. Until next time.